Hello and welcome back to Rob Mac Plays on the Epic Failure server. Glad to see everybody joining us today. A couple things here. First off, you can see I got myself a new texture pack. It's not looking too bad. I do have it backed up by some vanilla stuff, so we'll see how that all works out. I just kind of got things going. I also wanted to announce some changes to the format of the channel. We've been, since the beginning of the year, we have been live streaming Wednesday evenings, 7 p.m. Central, United States time. And that's always been on the server here. And we're going to continue to do that. And that may even expand to maybe Mondays and Wednesdays. If there is, a desire for more content or there's more going on, but at this point in time, I just don't like to have the videos and then the live stream. And sometimes the videos then don't come out or I have to really delay a lot of things and do a lot of different things. So I want to split doing recorded videos from doing the live stream. So this is going to be the last video on the server. And we'll be starting up a new series. That is yet to be determined what that's going to be. I haven't made any final decisions. Sorry as I'm finding things and replacing some of this glass. So yeah, this server will still be available. We're still looking for more people. We'd like to get a few more people involved. Right now we are sitting at... I didn't even think about that. Let's see, we have 2, 3, 4, 5, we have 6 active members on here, a few others that aren't quite as active. We also have a lot of other people that have made commitments to join, so we're looking forward to that as well. But we'd like to maybe even double our numbers, so if this is something you're interested in, the base cost is $5 per month. That just helps offset the cost of the server. I don't make any money off of it. It's not my intention to do so. Matter of fact, if we end up with more people on here, then more people are paying in, then we'll either reduce the cost or we will upgrade, update, create additional worlds, something that will make use of those funds. So we're looking forward to that. Also, in today's video, I did want to go over some of the things that we had been working on in the videos, just to kind of close those issues out. As you can tell, I do have the cart is running around. I got 2 carts right now running through, really doing nothing because I stopped the tree farm. We did a lot of this work in the live streams last couple weeks. You can see here, though, I have maxed out wood, saplings. Apples are at 156 stacks. I think we're doing pretty good. So I shut the farm off. I should probably actually just stop the carts. But I don't know. I like the sound of the carts. And it shows me some differences, too. When they're empty, how they're not always hitting everything. Although they're stopping at this one. They seem to overrun here, which I think just happens to do with the amount of force that's coming up here. I'm going to take that out, actually, and see if that resolves our issue. But all the timing and all that stuff is set up. If you didn't catch the live stream, we pulled Railcraft out of the system. Oh, much better. We pulled the Railcraft mod out of it. Because it was affecting the physics and the tracks and stuff too much. So that is how things are going on that end. But like I said, I kind of wanted to wrap up on a few things that were happening. I think I got rid of all the entire rest of that block a couple days ago. And I found the one bit that was missing. So this is / was the... power gen that's using the canola out there. not fully covered as far as everything is going, but I did want to show you how everything is kind of cleaned up here. We still have our generators here and a well we could build more and more of, running two of the 5 mil capacitor banks. So that looks really good. This, I just have my Energizer here because it looks pretty good. We have a farmer regulated by ME level emitter as to when it can draw things in. As you can tell right now, we don't need that. That's a piece of dirt that should be there. I didn't even realize I had another egg in there. Have any dirt hanging around somewhere? I'd like a piece of dirt. Give me that dirt. This is where the chest was. I could probably clean that up too. Like I said, slowly just finishing everything up here. Here's our mid-level then. Starting with, let's see. Yeah, matter of fact, let me pull this out while we're talking here. Let's see. Since we're not using this system anymore, we just can't get to anything anymore. Hey. Darn it. That's all that noise. Why are you not letting me? There we go. I probably have to just, again, not a big deal tearing this stuff down. It's not like I'm hurting for canola anymore. Which I am far from that, by the way. Let's see. You can see here we've got plenty of stuff in the system here, so less worried about that. We'll pick up the stuff we got, though, and throw it in the system. Get ourselves reorganized here. I think that's everything. Alright. Let's cover that up and talk about what we've got going on down here now. So, the ME network is pulling them out again. Here's where our farmer is, pulling them down. We've got a disk drive over here. I had a 4K just sitting around, so that seemed to work okay. I chose a disk drive, the drive over the chest, just because if we want to reuse it, we've got it available. So, system's pretty much the same thing, right? Canola press, pressing into the iron drum. What you won't see is a lot of the facade work. There we go. I wish. So just quickly go to where I want it to. There we go. So here you can see. So we're running the oil down and up over back into the fermenting barrels, into the iron drum, and then it's going across. I left these where they were. I just didn't want to tear them apart. Just substituted in everything. So again, going into the fluid placer, all that's controlled by the circuit. So it looks to make sure we have seeds, that we have fluid, that we have got everything else that we need. And right now you got crystallized oil there, and of course there's no room for that. This barrel is full of this drum, and same thing here going into the empowered oil. So looking good there. We also have then this dropper set up with a interface here for automatically crafting the seeds that we need here. We also have it set up down here so that all the empowering that's needed, it can be done on demand. So that is the fully automated system there. So other than doing some decoration, that should be fine. I may set one of these up downstairs just for personal use, although I do have them set to 64 at a time. So once it get it needs one, it'll cut stack. It'll do a whole stack at a time. We got a lot of stuff now that we can kind of drop off, or do we want? This is all the extra stuff that I got. We could probably clear these. Since these were what we were using before to take care of our seeds and things. So we're looking pretty good here. This puts out 350 RF a tick per machine. There's 10 of them there, so 3,500 RF a tick when it's needed. It's outputting 179. Got a little bit going on. We're also hooked into the immersive engineering lines. If I need to, I can just go back in here right now. So if I say input, then it's going to take it out from there and put it in here. Output then obviously makes this the primary system and that the secondary system. So doesn't really matter to me with it being the town's power. I think everything's working okay there. Let's kind of continue along. Nothing's changed in this one. I just noticed I'm running into some issues with this not pouring out properly. I'm not sure if it has to do with one of the new players that was on made some changes. So, I mean, it says the progress is done. It's not extracting out the bottom like it should. Let's just hop down here real quick. So he keeps saying it gets to 100% and then is doing nothing. Progress hits. Nothing happens. So I wonder if we wanna pull that out. We're gonna throw this back into insert mode as well. We're gonna pull it all out. And then we'll switch this back to insert mode. This back to extract mode. Now, if it's working, I'll reset right away. So I don't know if it dumped out. Let's see. No. Something's broken here. So we'll have to take a look at that. Let's see. As far as these go, I've slowly been stripping out bits and pieces to go into the new system. As you can see here, there's now holes in here. To go into my personal area, I will probably gut this out a little bit and then go into leaving the mod filters so that we can just build into those and leave some stuff for spawn to be that way. A lot has kind of changed here. Anduria Mining Corp. And the mining. Well, we don't really have a mining shaft anymore, and you'll see that. Here's our Ender IO machines, and this is where it used to be. But this is now our mob grinder. We've got wither skeletons right now. Pretty basic setup here. Turn a lever on, boom, wither skeletons, and then they're killed by the mob grinder down here at a pretty decent rate. So, looking good there. It does take a significant amount of power. But we do have a lever on the mob grinder as well in case we need to come in and get something specifically. A lot of times the experienced solidifier is able to get stuff as well. So, All right, looking good there. And then we do have a few. We got Enderman and Ghasts right now as well. So not doing too bad for a little bit of time we've had this running. 13 Wither Skeleton Skulls. A lot of other stuff, so looking pretty good there. Otherwise, again, not much is really changing here. Just kind of moving things around. Getting rid of those the swords that they drop. And then I can kind of just pick apart what I need and get going from there. So, not too bad. Let's see. As far as the central part while we're here, nothing's changed with the exception of these farmers that we put in place so we can automatically pick the farms. I don't have them pumping anywhere. Just figured I can come and grab what I need. I usually don't need that many stacks, so looking good there. But Steve's cart running the tree farm now. Again, we shut that off just because of the sheer volume of stuff we have. So we won't need this running again for a while. Oh, there we go. Galgadorian hull and tools, so we don't have to repair them. Advanced smelter to smelt our oak wood into charcoal for use in the coal engine. Plant to range set at 2x2 right now, just given the size of where we're at. And then the woodcutter. You can see here, there's Galgadorian hull, coal engine, Galgadorian woodcutter, the side chests, which gives us this amount of room. Don't really need much more than that with how small this area is. The advanced smelter and the planter range extender. So, but we just disabled the engine. It can sit there. These carts just running empty now. Coming out of the cargo manager, up and over into the hopper. Carts come in. Go ahead. Hop in there. There's a detector rail timer right now, just taking about 12 seconds and then kicking them out. And they're running pretty good because they're running empty. They've been overrunning a little bit, but nothing too bad. This building hasn't changed. Our little buddy here still this fisherman who's been offering us some good exchanges, like 28 coal for an emerald. We've really been taking advantage of some other things. I think it's because we took the railcraft stuff out. Right here, a minecart for 8 emeralds. That's where we've been really doing that. Otherwise, I'm not sure if these images aren't here because of that, or if those are other railcraft things, but that's pretty much what we've been doing. Same with here, just the nether portal and the deep dark portal. Alright, over here we have our little farming spots. this is fun because when Mickle was over here looking at it, he died a lot. These are mob filters from Dark Utilities. So when we feed them, the babies go down automatically. Let's see, how much is in these feeders? Yes, there should be some down there. Let's see if we can do this without... So as you can see here then, we've got the vector planes, so as they fall through, they get shot down here, and then the reverse mob filter babies. So only babies can go through here. Anything but babies should be able to go through here. So we do that. Everything flies through. And then after that, they head over here and hit the spikes. And then we also have... The only thing we don't have, it looks like, is the experience solidifier or something to pick that up. Otherwise, we also had chickens over here for a while. What happens is these grates, if anything, only allows items through and not anything else. Let's see here. There's our dirt RFL, but let's throw something down like this sapling. Look at the sapling and see how that falls right through, and then should end up, there it is. So that's how we ended up with 416 stacks of eggs and 58 stacks of feathers. So everything else is coming along. Right now I've been really pushing the sheep, which is probably running a little. Nope, they're still doing it. Because we need the wool for the applied energistics dense cable. So on to the other big project that we're doing in the videos. That would be... Oh, sorry about that. That would be the immersive engineering buildings here. And I'm not going to go into too much detail, but everything here, the biggest thing we needed to do was cover everything up yet. And we're definitely got that taken care of. Just need to get a couple more of the conduit facades to cover up the last little bits. Otherwise, this has been functioning very well. It is nearly self-sufficient right now. Right here, the only big thing is that this obsidian hoe needs to be replaced every 8,000 uses. So, it's something we just keep an eye on. I'm more than likely going to be needing to do some quick automation with that. So, we could probably take this out soon. And we could even... Well, since we're running this here, we could run the power and those in the same place and gain one more square. But again, not doing too bad. Let's see. We are sitting on... 24 stacks of seeds, so not horrible in any stretch of the imagination. This must be Mickles. I know he was working on one. It should tell me. I mean, that's my grid power, but. This should be his construction. Because that's mine over there. Usually. Maybe because I'm the... I'm opt on the server, it will let me do anything. But normally you can't affect other people's stuff. So, for those of you that haven't had a chance to, here is my house. I'm still working on a few things like the tops of the pillars, but I chiseled out the marble pillar so that we could create a circular pillar. The tops and bottoms are rectangular because they're painted glowstone, so they provide light. Still got to figure out some other things here for light, but we've got some ideas coming along the way. So then chiseled out some of the bases here, and the same thing up here. Working on... just finishing up. See if we can find one that's completed. This is the look we're going for. So from down here, it just looks like that. From the sides, it creates the line. And then the bases will all look like this. So this is a completed one. So that's what it's going to look like. And then at the top of our pyramid, right now, you got gold blocks. We're going to chisel them into some type of statue. And these look a lot better in this mod pack than they do. I'm almost afraid to chisel them. Again, we chiseled the entrance here. Using some more marble pillar. I just chiseled it so that it wasn't just blocky. I think it turned out pretty nice here. And I could, if I wanted to, round, make this look more round. And even maybe it trails up into here. But overall, I think it turned out really good. Kind of doing a mix of Caesar Greek, Cleopatra Egyptian. So this is what this looks like. I walled in here. And then we're using sneaky false blocks. There we go. So this is where I started getting things together. Right now, it's just a work in progress. So we have all the some drawers. So it's starting to move some stuff out. And it keeps throwing stuff in drawers. So as we start using them up, we'll start marking them. And then down here is where the drive is starting to happen. This is the super stupid drive. That we're working on. not too bad right now. Was able to automate all the inscribers. Got a couple of crafting CPUs going. Oh, we can turn this off now, since we're not using those anymore. And then, like I said, we need some dense cable because we're going to run the 8s this way. And then we'll run dense cable towards the center here. This is the center of the pyramid. So we'll have the ME controllers set up here and have dense cables connecting to them. And we'll probably end up recentering things a little bit. Because as you can see, this should run to about here. In fact, I can probably mark that. Since it's the center, we'll probably slide that in a little bit more. Be able to do a little bit more automation on the sides or something. And then the next floor down will be our power generation, which we are still looking at a few options for. I want to get off of the city's power, which I am currently doing through... I don't know if you saw that, but... through there. That long tunnel heads over back over by the... To the farm space behind the Ender IO room. So yeah, from here it just kicks all the way out here and it connects in down here right there. So this will obviously be covered again soon once we get the rail running. So that's about all of that. So again, I appreciate you guys watching the videos. I definitely get a lot of response from that. And go ahead, throw a comment in there. If you guys like this, maybe, I mean, I could continue doing this if you guys like the more individualized, you know, 30-minute or so sessions. I just don't want to be holding myself back when it comes to what's going on the live stream and what's going on in the videos. So looking at either just a different mod pack in Minecraft, or maybe we just try a different game. So, which I'm not opposed to. I am already in a couple other games doing things. So other than that, reach down there, hit that like button. If you're not already... if you're not subscribed to the channel, doing so will let you know also when I am live streaming, which again, right now is currently Wednesdays, 7 p.m. Central Time. Like I said, it'll also let you know if I'm going to be doing things more on there. We'll also have the rest of the website running next week, and all those details will come up in the other videos. So with that, again, for myself, Rob Mack, other members on the Epic Failure server, we appreciate you guys coming and taking a look around, and we hope that you head over to Buycraft, go ahead and buy a subscription, and jump on with us. We really appreciate it. And with that, again, I'm Rob Mack, and remember, it's a game. Have fun.